81st all-time meeting as the Carolina Hurricanes get set for the Ottawa Senators. And we bring you back inside the RBC Center. Craig Anderson in goal for the Sens. He was victorious over Columbus on Saturday night with 21 saves, 2-0-2 lifetime against Carolina. And Cam Ward last played on Friday night in St. Louis. What did he do? Well, 40 saves, first star, in a 3-2 overtime loss against the Blues. The officials tonight, the referees are Mike Hasenfratz and Francis Charron, with Brian Pancic and Tim Nowak on the lines.
And you see Paul Maurice and his coaching staff, Tom Barrasso, Dave Lewis, are wearing the Hockey Fights cancer ties on this great night.
And so are we, along with Bob Harwood, our good friend Chuck Caton. Sit back and enjoy this one from the RBC Center. First of four between these two teams. The Canes coming off a four-game road swing at 2-1-1. Ottawa's won two games in a row. In back of the goal now, Brandon Sutter for Brian Allen. His shot blocked on the way through by Milan McCulloch. It's loose, and Patrick Dwyer's on it for Carolina. Around the boards this way for a pinching Brian Allen. Allen goes to work on McCulloch, broken up by Erik Karlsson, who's third among defensemen in scoring, off to a good start as the Sens try to clear, and Filip Kuba turns it over. Sutter with a shot blocked by Colin Greening, and it goes out of play.
Paul Maurice's hockey club had to clear customs and return from Winnipeg about 3 o'clock Sunday morning. He gave the team the day off. They had a good practice yesterday in preparation for being back at home. And Zach Boychuk was recalled today. It'll be fun to watch him play on that fourth line.
In the place of Anthony Stewart, a shot by Jamie McBain is blocked on the way through. Mika Zibanejad, the young rookie, 18 years of age, playing his ninth game, and that's important because they need to make a decision on him tomorrow in terms of staying or going to Sweden back to play in the Swedish Elite League. Now it's chipped ahead by Tuomo Ruutu. Erik Staal, Ruutu with a heavy hit on the forecheck, and Alexei Ponikarovsky on this line. Carolina goes to work on the forecheck, and out of the corner now, it's carried by Chris Neal back out to center ice.
Well, that's the kind of thing this line needs. Two hits from Ruutu and then one from Ponikarovsky on their first shift.
Ruutu had four hits in Winnipeg on Saturday night. He scored a beautiful goal set up by Jeff Skinner. Down the trapezoid, played legally by Craig Anderson. Chris Phillips, the veteran, moves it off for Erik Kondra back out to center ice. Jussi Jokinen had it, he lost it. It was a bouncing puck. Zach Smith, his lead pass broken up by Chad LaRose, and back out to the center zone where the Senators regroup. Zach Smith, who scored against Columbus in that win Saturday night, clears it ahead. Thomas Caberle goes D to D for Jay Harrison. Jeff Skinner taken care of by Filip Kuba. And Jussi Jokinen gets it deep.
Ottawa actually plays a very similar style to the Detroit Red Wings. And when you think about it, that's no surprise considering where head coach Paul MacLean has come from. It is very similar to the way they stack up in the neutral zone to the Red Wings.
Canes now start from their own zone. Tim Brent for Brett Sutter. Sutter now moves it by David Rundblad. A good look at Chris Phillips, bumped on the play by Zach Boychuk. Tim Brent goes after it on a cycle. He'll keep it deep. Around the boards this way and coming back down the wall and feeding it off is Jesse Winchester. Phillips turns it over. Good pinch by McBain. And when the Canes were on their game on the road, that's what we saw.
Yeah, that goes back to what they wanted to do throughout the year, is be more aggressive with their defense. The only way you can do it is if you have support like they did there from the high forward.
Brett Sutter with his back to the play. Now Tim Brent shrugging off Zenon Konopka. The fourth line centers for both teams go to work in the corner. Brent on Konopka. Jason Spezza fires across. Sergei Gonchar this way. Rundblad. David Rundblad lost his footing. He's bumped down by Brett Sutter. Now it's fed ahead by McCulloch. Inside for Spezza. Quick hitter. Paddle down for Cam Ward. And now picking an options off for Boychuk. And away they go. Brett Sutter gets it deep. The Canes need a line change, and they get it.
They did, because Ottawa was able to come out with their first line, the Spezza line, against Carolina's fourth line at the end of the shift. But I thought Boychuk and Sutter did a good job taking the shooting lanes away on the points.
Milan McCulloch goes deep. Brian Allen for Carolina. The pass picked off by Gonchar. He'll move it wide. Jared Callen's shot kicked out with a purpose by Cam Ward. Colin Greening goes to work on Tim Gleason. Greening inside for Spezza. Jason Spezza holding onto it. Moving up is the young rookie defenseman Callen. He's hog-tied a bit by Dwyer. Spezza, nice pass. Here's Greening, his shot tipped A loose puck cleared but not out. Greening has control. Colin Greening holding again. Off a stick, off Gleason, and it goes out of play.
Papa Judge is cheering on. Here is a man that does not need to grow a mustache in Movember. He has always had that mustache. Fine NHL hockey career spanning 11 seasons. And, you know, talking to veteran Jason Spezza about Paul McLean this morning, he says Paul McLean has confidence in himself, and that exudes to the entire locker room.
Yeah, he's a great guy. The last 6 years, an assistant in Detroit. Chris Neal out in front. Good save by Cam Ward on a slashing Nick Foligno. Alexei Ponikarovsky feeds it by Erik Karlsson. Chris Neal takes a hit from Ponikarovsky. Now Caberle at the point for Carolina goes deep. Ponikarovsky in back of Craig Anderson, utilizing his size. Back to the point, Caberle, he'll swing across. Harrison shot blocked by Foligno. Chris Neal in control. He leads the NHL with 46 penalty minutes, and he gets it deep.
Foligno was shaken up, blocking that Harrison one-timer.
Games now from their own zone. Harrison picked off by Runblad, and now Phillips. Moves it in a stretch pass, and it's centered all the way across by the newcomer, just up, Kaspar's Dog of Ennis. And now it's played along the boards. Broken up here. And now cleared by Harrison, back out to center ice. Skinner over the line. Skinner with a drag move, blocker down by Anderson. Now it goes deep. Now it's played along the boards and cleared again, and looking to get it out is Erik Condra. He's upended. Skinner goes behind Anderson with it. Phillips now moves it off of Runblad, and they'll organize. Now a clear. Good play by Skinner. Better stop by Anderson. The rebound goes high. The shot taken by Joni Pikkanen, and it careens all the way back.
Boy, that was a perfect forechecking system when you look at it. You had two players, LaRose and Jokinen, deep, and Skinner is the high forward. And all of a sudden, the high forward gets a great chance. He's in the right spot to be a good defense outlet, but then can jump in and try to score.
Icing called here against Carolina. We'll swing it back in Cam Ward's end.
Now Cam Ward, his save percentage, when you look at it, has been on a steady climb. There he had to be sort of casual about finding his way around Caberle, who was coming through the crease. Good poise there from the man that had 3 points on Saturday night. The work was done down low by UC and Chad.
Senin Konopka over 60% in the circle last year with the New York Islanders. Up over 50% this year. Had over 300 minutes in penalties last year with the Islanders. That led the NHL. He was signed as a free agent centering this line. Brett Sutter now moving up on Gonchar. Tough angle. He'll fire across. Now top of your screen. Jay Harrison had his stick lifted, and it comes out to center ice. Pikkanen now goes D to D for Jay Harrison. Your neutral ice chipped ahead on a line change by Tim Brent. In back of the goal, Boychuk is after it for Carolina. The Senators collapse back. McCulloch in the skates of Cowan, and again out to center.
Omaries told me this morning that even without Stewart playing, bringing up Boychuk from Charlotte, he wants to be a four-line team, and he's delivered on that promise. That's the second shift, and two good shifts for that fourth trio.
Cam Ward out to play at 13:40 left to go in this first period. John Forslund, Tripp Tracy, Bob Harwood with you from the RBC Center, where the Canes will play 7 of their next 10. And now crossing that Ottawa line is Brian Allen, and the play is whistled dead offside. 13:29 left to go in this first period. We are scoreless in Raleigh.
Look at Brian Allen along with Tim Gleason. The number one shutdown pairing is going to be busy tonight. And from ice level, what we've watched so far is a team that's held the Senators to just 2 shots. We're only about 4.5 minutes in, or 5.5 minutes in. But John and Tripp, as we bring you guys back in, they're really, really conscious about work around Cam Ward so far. You can see that the objective is limit the quality of chances, limit the number, and that's something that they've had to refocus on. There were barrages in the early going on Cam Ward through the road trip especially.
Two things, Bob. Brian Allen did a good job in one instance of not leaving the front of the net. He read the play perfectly, and Tim Gleason should know Jason Spezza very well because they were teammates once upon a time with the Windsor Spitfires.
13:24 left to go in the opening period. The Canes will stay home and take on Chicago on Friday night. As the Hawks come in, we start with Hurricanes live at 6:30. Tim Gleason walks the line, keeps it deep. Brandon Sutter tries to scamper away from Philip Trouba. Sutter's pass broken up by Colin Greening, and out they go. Colin Greening now will scale it along the boards. This way, fielded by Sutter. Angled nicely off the wall and cleared out. Carlson coming back, dogged by Dwyer. Dwyer's in, Henderson hangs on, no further play.
Well, I mean, that's not an easy play for Brandon Sutter, and he does it with ease. Just a little scoop, you've got to get this puck out if you're Brandon. You know, he just indirects it and lofts it at the same time, and then the speed of Dwyer. Good job of being able to get that puck on his tape by Dwyer, and a good save from Anderson.
Off the draw, McBain point to point. Here's Pickenin off a stick, off Chris Neal. Tuomo Ruutu in back of the goal, up top he goes. McBain will dust it off, it's tipped by Ruutu wide. Hammered by Pickenin, it goes high. Scales off the glass, eludes McBain. You see it come all the way down to Cam Ward.
Joni Pickenin continues to shoot without hesitation. He did that on the road trip. He scored the first goal in the last hockey game here against Boston.
Shots are 3-2 Carolina in the early going. A long pass from Jamie McBain is iced. He went by Ponikarovsky and will swing the faceoff all the way back. Rex Healthcare, injuries and scratches.
Anthony Stewart is hopeful that he may be able to play on the weekend against Chicago and Philadelphia. Jocelyn and Falk are healthy. Justin Falk went down and played very well in three games for Jeff Daniels, two of them victories. Zach Tulpe's making progress, but has yet to get back on the ice.
Yeah, Justin Falk has practiced the last 2 days with the Hurricanes, and now in back of the goal, walking out. Dogovins with a shot, and a good save by Cam Ward. This is Kaspars Dogovins, a Latvian brought up from Binghamton, playing only his second NHL game.
Well, those types of plays can be a dog, John, because every part of a goaltender wants to leave his short side post. I mean, this is a player that played very well for Binghamton in the Calder Cup playoffs last year and had a great training camp, and that thing looked to be labeled. Good stop.
It was Binghamton that ousted Charlotte in the semifinals for the Calder Cup, and they went on to win, and Dogovins was a big part of that. Now Zach Smith, Eric Condra. Condra with a shot to the goal mouth, unattainable. Jared Callen walks down the boards with it. Callen holding onto it. Inside it goes for Condra. Indirect pass all the way back for Smith. Zach Smith, turning stick of Callen. His shot blocked in front by Harrison. The Canes try to clear. The puck is loose, and Zach Smith does a good job. Condra for Dogovins. Kaspars Dogovins will leave it there, and now moving across is Jussi Jokinen. Nice pinch by Jared Callen, moving down the wall on Chad LaRose. Thomas Caberle for the Canes. Plays it, offers partner Jay Harrison. Off a stick, off Skinner. It comes all the way back. This will be icing again with Jared Callen on the touch.
Ottawa looks like a team that has the confidence of winning two straight. Let's watch Chad LaRose. Communication so important in the game of hockey. Look at Harrison. I'm going to take the guy below the screen. You get the guy in front of the net. And he does so on Dogovins very well. That's Chad LaRose, very cerebral defensive forward.
Jason Spezza and his group now. They get a favorable matchup. Tired troops out for Carolina. Carlson shot blocker down by Cam Ward. LaRose springs Skinner. Jeff Skinner moves in, played well by Greening. He gets a shot off. That's stopped by Anderson. So Jeff Skinner had obviously a lot left in the tank as it comes back.
That's all about LaRose's conditioning. He is as fit as any Carolina player. He had to stay on the ice because of icing and still has the wherewithal after Cam Ward's explosive save to find Skinner for a chance in transition. Good play by Chad LaRose, recognizing that Skinner had a step on Greening. Greening did a good job, didn't he?
He did.
He did. He's a forward coming back there. That's a fine play.
Ottawa, and they've admitted this, they're in a rebuild. There's no doubt about it. They're breaking in so many young players, a hand pass off the faceoff, we get a stoppage.
They almost are like one of those dangerous teams in the second half of the season that isn't going to make the playoffs. And you never know what can happen. Boy, they've had a strong start. But they're willing to take some chances, be creative. I give their leadership core, and so does Paul McLean, a lot of credit. A week ago tonight, they had a bad loss against the Philadelphia Flyers on home ice. With a young team, I think they could have, you know, let it go a little bit. They had a players-only meeting, and they've responded with two wins.
They lost that game 7-2. They've had two touchdown games. That's what Paul McLean calls those. Two games where they allow seven goals. And if you commit to young players, you have to live with that, and everybody has to stick together.
And they have done that. And their leadership guys, whether it be Spezza, Mahalik, they've all responded in action.
Tuomo Ruutu moves it by David Runblad. A good look at Chris Phillips, who's finished off by Eric Staal in the forecheck. Now Phillips in back of Anderson. Runblad has room. He was the top defenseman in the Swedish Elite League a season ago with 51 scoring points. Greeny bumped a bit by Jamie McBain this way. Played along the boards by Pona Karofsky. Gonchar read the play. McCulloch goes deep. Spencer's awaiting the pass. Given a shove by Pickenin. Played by Colin Greening. They go to the corner. Coming down on him is Brandon Sutter. Greening now. Stays sturdy on it. Holding onto that puck. Handing off to McCulloch. In a seam is Gonchar. Good stick by Pickenin. Racing across Jared Callen. He'll go deep. Greening along the wall. Met there by Sutter. Colin Greening leaves it there. It pops out. McBain defends. McCulloch is on him. Now Spezza. Jason Spezza's pass outside the blue line. And the Senators reorganize.
I think that's a good read by Joni Pittman. He easily could have left the back door on that play, and instead, that's his guy. And he gets a stick on that passing attempt.
Here comes Gonchar, and the Sens are offside. 9:23 left to go in period one. Eric Staal lays the body on the forecheck on Chris Phillips, and that is good to see. Well, have you ever wondered what goes on the off days? Well, we ask some probing questions. And here's Tripp with the latest.
If you had your choice, you could only meet Bieber or Gomez, who would you choose?
Probably Selena Gomez. I think my sister would choose Bieber, but I'd probably choose Selena Gomez.
That, of course, is in reference to the fact that both Justin Bieber and this Selena Gomez were at the game in Winnipeg on Saturday night and saw Jeff Skinner put together a three-point display. And I told Jeff in the airport that they were there. He had no idea. And it was like, our generation, John, if we had been playing in a game and the Rolling Stones were there. I mean, the whole flight back, he was totally flabbergasted about it. Pretty cool. And, hey, once again, he makes the right decision. Gomez, not Bieber.
Might be Guy Lombardo in my case. Now comes out to center ice. You don't even know who that is, do you?
Nope.
Okay, now it's fed ahead by Chad LaRose. And the Sens now reorganize. 8:55 left to go in this first period. Scoreless hockey. John Tripp and Bob along with our crew, as always, on Fox Sports Carolina's. Jared Callen is away for Ottawa, looking for Nick Foligno. A loose puck to the corner, Gleason side. He's hogtied on the way through, and Carolina will be going on the power play. Nick Foligno will be going for holding as the Canes now have six skaters out. Ottawa gets possession, and the Canes go to the power play.
And Hassenfratz makes the call. It's going to be a hold on Foligno. Remember, it was Foligno that blocked that shot in pain to Jay Harrison earlier in the period, just trying to get the inside track. And you see the use of the left arm. I'm sure Guy was a good guy, though.
He was. And it was Guy, not Guy.
Well, that's why I said Guy.
I know.
I'm all about pronunciations.
Just for our audience. It wasn't you. Don't get
sensitive. Some good power plays that the Hurricanes had against Winnipeg. They felt they really had a ton of chances, and Mason was forced to make some A-caliber saves.
Canes power play ranked number 20. At home, number 21. Caberle holding on to it. Ottawa has been really given a problem with the penalty killing this season as they are 29th, 18th on the road. And the penalty killing is under 70%. Harrison now moves it off. Bending on the pass, Tuomo Ruutu. Chad LaRose in the corner. LaRose centers one off the body, one off Philip Kuba, not out. Harrison with a shot tipped right on. Anderson hangs on, and no further play.
That's just a hard-working power play group. I mean, sometimes you forget when you have a 5-on-4, you still have to outwork the other team. And Chad LaRose, I think, has had a very strong start to this game. Finished a check, came up with a puck, then you had the net drive. Caberle and Harrison playing a little catch. And that's where Pona Karofsky needs to be, whether it be on the power play or even strength. Right there in front of Anderson all night long.
Staal, Skinner, Jokinen up front. McBain and Pickenin are back. 1:26 left to go in this power play. Sergei Gonchar off the faceoff. A lucky bounce for Carolina. He'll trap the zone. Skinner goes inside for Jokinen. Back to the point. Joni Pickenin hits a rolling puck. McBain settles it down. Now Skinner from the half boards. He's guarded by Kondra and Cowan. Skinner now up top again. Holding on to it, Joni Pickenin. He'll walk the line. Skinner looks for a lane. Shoots one, denied by Anderson. Loose out in front. Jokinen off for Skinner one more time. Skinner again. This way it's McBain. He'll right the ship. Hammered by Pickett and tipped right on. Good save by Anderson. Loose in back of the goal. Dug out again by Skinner, but fielded by Jason Spezza, who gets it out.
See, it's a tough thing to do, but if there's any chance that Jamie McBain can get himself in a position to one-time that hard pass from Skinner, that's when you're really going to find some daylight.
Entry pass for Stahl, picked off by Dogovins, loose along the boards. Kaspar's Dogovins after it, and now McCulloch sends it back for Kuba. Eric Karlsson will slam it. Gilmore time, but he's set up. Milan McCulloch with a couple of pretty moves, but a good job by Jamie McBain. Final push, 16 seconds on the power play. Here's Tuomo Ruutu. Ruutu to the outside of McCulloch, holding onto it. His pass off of Karlsson. He gets it back. He'll stop on a dime. Put on a little bit of a show here, but Dogovins has control. He'll salt away more time, and now Nick Foligno is up and ready, and he is sent out of that penalty box as Ottawa's killed it off. Through the middle, Winchester. Over the line, good sweep, checked by Brandon Sutter. Tuomo Ruutu lends a helping hand. He's sealed off by Foligno, and now Runblad through the middle. An aerial pass, you see it come all the way back in Kane's ice, and icing is called here against Ottawa.
This was not an easy play for Jamie McBain. Short-handed, dealing with a player coming with a full head of steam. Nice job. Just keep that Ottawa crest between you and the goal, and then use your stick at the right time. I mean, you have one of the NHL's young season's leading goal scorers in the former San Jose Shark, McCulloch there. Good play.
Canes had three shots with the power play, one scoring chance. 6:16 left to go in period one. Zach Smith, Brent Sutter on the draw. Brent shot, fended off by Craig Anderson. Karlsson leads it for Zach Smith. Runblad now deep in his own zone. He'll take a hit, try to make a play. And good forechecking by Boychuk. Better save by Anderson. Zach Boychuk makes it happen.
I talked to Charlotte's fine head coach, Jeff Daniels, right before the game. And he said the biggest thing that Zach Boychuk has been able to do after a training camp and preseason where it just didn't go his way, the former first-round pick, is regain his swagger. And he's been doing that with a point-of-game production level for Charlotte. I mean, that's a confident play. That's a skill play. The big thing for Boychuk, too, is that when he's been called up in the past, he's learned the other areas of the game to be an all-around player.
Brett Sutter takes another face-off. They win it. Now it's Pickett into an open corner. Boychuk ahead of Karlsson. Brett Sutter. Zibanejad is on him. Now Boychuk once again. Tries to stop and start on Eric Karlsson. Boychuk to the point. One-timer McBain nullified by Foligno, who lost his stick. Boychuk goes deep for Sutter. Brett Sutter in back of Anderson. Throws on the brakes. Holding onto it away from Kuba. Up top again, McBain. This way it's Joni Pikkanen. He'll dust it off a couple of times. Pikkanen walks. Heels away from McBain. To the wall he goes. Blockered down by Anderson. It's loose for Karlsson, but not out. Sealed off by Boychuk. Now it's played nicely by Tim Brett. Pikkanen swings across again for McBain. Right back for 25. Pikkanen again. Now McBain looked at by Foligno. McBain now dealt away for Joni Pikkanen. Little spin on Neal. His shot is swallowed by Craig Anderson. And we get a stoppage. 5:09 left to go in the first period. Good shift for Zach Boychuk. Elevated today from the American Hockey League. I kidded my partner about some of the off-color things we may do on an off day. Well, this is the serious stuff right here. Hard work in the face-off circle with Rod Brind'Amour.
Well, look at three of your centers. You have Stahl on one side, Sutter on the other. Of course, Brind'Amour is dropping these pucks, and you have Jokinen. But look at the intensity in Rod's coaching. I mean, that's the biggest thing that he talks about. He talks about your hands, you know, with face-offs, but really, it's your care level. It's your bear down factor. And you can just see it there in his body language. Dropping those pucks, he really cares.
And Ottawa's 10th best in the league in terms of faceoff acumen coming in over 50%. Actually over 53% as a team. McCulloch going deep on Brian Allen. Now Colin Greening, Milan McCulloch, side of the goal. Centers one. Good stick by Dwyer. Kuba plays it deep. Greening has the pass. He's flushed out by Yuri Talusti. Colin Greening. Again for Milan McCulloch. Loose and back of the goal. Greening gets there. McCulloch hits a hole. It's a loose puck as we see. Patrick Dwyer down the wall. Around the boards this way. Erik Karlsson with a wrister. Good save by Cam Ward. A little bit of traffic out in front. Now McCulloch pinned a bit by Gleason. They jam for it. McCulloch gets to it. Now walking it is Jason Spezza. Back to the point. Philip Kuba off the wall. Karlsson chopping it. One blocked by Tulowski. The Canes having a tough time getting it out. Allen tries again. Third attempt by Brian Allen, and they do get it out. Here's Patrick Dwyer. Brandon Sutter. Tulowski's the trailer. He's in. Bodied down by Anderson. Now Dwyer goes inside for Brandon Sutter. Tied up by Erik Karlsson. They scrum for it. You see it up close. Harrison. Konakarowski. Good save by Anderson.
Well, a couple good things happened here. First of all, Carolina, I thought, was very patient in a good way in their defensive zone coverage. And then Sutter, with his explosive stride, worked the puck up the ice, and the Canes were able to make a line change without the puck abandoning the Ottawa zone. Good save by Anderson. Now, Ponikarovsky, he's fresh off the bench. Good look from Harrison, I believe it is.
He was. Camberley with a shot through heavy traffic, broken up by Kondra. And out they go. Erik Kondra off the boards. He took a hit. It was a good one that time by Harrison. Carolina gets to it. Erik Staal through the middle all the way back. Chris Phillips on his horse ahead of Tuomo Ruutu. David Runblad in front of Anderson. Starts it out to center ice. Here's Zach Smith. At the Carolina line, it deflects. It goes by Kondra. Staal back for the Canes, and now Caberlet is on it. Time and space for Jay Harrison. Center zone, Tuomo Ruutu. Flung back deep by Ottawa, Zach Smith.
Well, it's still scoreless, but one of our game keys is limit Ottawa's transition, and thus far, they've had none.
Skinner moves in. He goes down. And now in back of the goal, the puck is loose. LaRose tries to dig it out. Zibanejad cut off by Jussi Jokinen. Now Foligno gets to it. Nick Foligno tries to move it out, and a penalty is called. Interference against Ottawa.
Now it's the back official that makes the call, Sharon. And it's going to be Jared Cowan, a good young defenseman, that is guilty of the minor. The Hurricanes will get their second power play of the period. Let's look for two in white. Yeah, away from the puck. Skinner thought he had drawn one on the entry. And he wondered there too, and the referee caught it.
Cowan was the ninth overall pick in 09. Paul Maurice now will send out his A unit on the power play. Jared Cowan gone for interference at 17:04. McBain and Pickenin on the point. Staal, Jokinen, and Skinner up front. Carolina had three shots with their first power play. Joni Pickenin. Quarterbacks away for Jussi Jokinen. Shoved this way for Erik Staal. Staal goes deep with it. Top of your screen, McBain. Now Joni Pickenin will settle it down. Along the wall, it's Staal. Midpoint, McBain. In the circle, Skinner, guarded by Phillips. Nice pass. Here's Pickenin all the way across. One pass too many. Now Skinner again. Out of the corner. Inside for the juice. Jussi Jokinen delays. Staal's out in front. There's a pass. A seam pass broken up. Staal tries to win a battle. The Senators get to it, and they dump it out.
I think there's more room to work it low to high to create down low.
Here's Skinner. Along the boards now. Staal again out in front. Jokinen, he's tackled on the play, and it's cleared out.
Boy, oh boy, and Jokinen looks over at Chiron, the referee, says, what do I need to do?
Wow.
That looked like that would have been a good play across the state for the Panthers in the NFL on Sunday.
Now Ruutu, Thomas Caberlet. Moves off a tough pass for Joni Pickenin. It's settled down along the wall by Ruutu. Konakarovsky broken up by Karlsson. There's LaRose for Carolina. Back it goes Caberlet. He'll walk the line. Thomas Caberlet down the wall. Pickenin out in front. Unattainable pass. Konakarovsky getting to it. LaRose. LaRose. Indirect pass off the stick of Konakarovsky. Karlsson tries to clear. Now Dogovins tries to do the same here for the Senators. They battle along the wall. Karlsson tries to clear, and McCulloch finally will.
Joni Pickenin has done a nice job. On these couple of power plays, he's never stationary. When I say low to high, I mean if they're congesting, that being Ottawa down low, work it to the points. That will open things up.
Harrison with a shot kicked out with a purpose by Craig Anderson. Fed ahead by Carolina's Patrick Dwyer. Here's Chris Phillips. Lots of time to set up Jason Spezza. He'll curl back. As the penalty has been killed again, Phillips holding on to it. Moved off on Brian Allen, who takes him down. Dwyer ahead of Smith, loosened back of the goal. Spence is there, so is Zach Smith. Looking for Jason Spezza. Harrison's clear, held in by Chris Phillips. One-timer Gonchar denied by Cam Ward to the corner now. With 27 seconds left in the period, Foligno inside for Smith. The ice taken away by Allen. Out of the corner, Sutter tries to clear. Callen hammers one, blocked off the hand of Dwyer, who's injured. And now it's carried out by Talusti. Gary Talusti's shot blockered down by Craig Anderson. He spits out a rebound, but Ottawa looks like they will survive with 7 seconds left to go in the period. Jared Callen off a stick, helped along by Chris Neal. Back out to neutral ice, and that'll do it.
Patrick Dwyer blocked that shot. It may have come with a price. With his speed, he very easily could have had a last-minute power play. We'll have to see if he returns the bench to begin the second period.
Papa John's is cheering on the Canes to victory this season. The Caniacs are the real winners. With a win tonight, all Caniacs receive 50% off their menu-priced online orders tomorrow at participating restaurants at papajohns.com. Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's. Zach Boychuk will be Bob Harwood's guest when we come back and kick off the RBC Bank first intermission. We are scoreless here in the capital city. The Carolina Hurricanes and the Ottawa Senators right here on Fox Sports Carolina. Carolina Hurricanes hockey on Fox Sports Carolinas is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina. By Rex Healthcare, Rex, chosen for excellence. And by Geico, 50 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
20 in the books in Raleigh. It's scoreless between the Senators and your Hurricanes, and the RBC Bank intermission report continues. Now, in Hurricanes Live, in our pregame show, we showed you part one of our tour of the dressing room. We emphasized sticks and the snack room, and Jay Harrison did some dishes, so there's always a surprise behind the closed doors of a team's dressing room. On the equipment side of things, here's part two of our tour of the Canes room with George Alves.
Okay, so we're back out into the working environment, and George, this is obviously a drying apparatus. We see these, they're usually lower to the ground during the games, but this is full team, full skates and gloves and stuff like that. And just to confirm, it doesn't smell any better than you guess it would.
No, that has to do a lot with the heat. It's got a heat element in it, which allows it to dry quicker. Right. A lot of these guys will use skates or gloves between periods, so we need to make sure that they get dried pretty quickly.
Yeah, that's always a pressing matter during a game. Take us into the equipment workshop, basically. Blade Master, of course, all the gear that adjusts the things on the skates, and possibly most importantly, your boss and everybody's friend, Wally Tatimer, here.
That's right.
In charge of blades especially. This is really impressive because it looks like there's a tool for every job you can imagine in hockey.
Well, there is. There's so many different things that we have to do with equipment, whether it be sewing equipment, repairing equipment, skates. Obviously, there's a lot of times you need to work on not only the skate blades, but also the boot itself. And we're fully equipped here to handle any type of situation that we might get.
This is a handyman's dream.
This is actually our game-ready stick room. So on our way out to the ice, the guys are fully equipped here with what they need. Most of them in here are already fully taped and ready to go.
I get the feeling from how proud you guys are of your workspace and the tools you work with that you feel there's a bit of a part of you on the ice with those guys. Am I right about that?
Absolutely. I mean, we carry their gear, we pack their gear, we sharpen their skates, but we also take pride in what we do for them to make sure that they were ready to take the ice on a night-to-night basis. So, there is a lot of pride in that.
Yep, he's part of a very special crew, and join us anytime you want. Go to Canes Vision on CarolinaHurricanes.com for looks behind the scenes in the world of hockey. Skip Cunningham, the senior of the senior crew, Bob Gorman, and Wally Tatimer, threw George the baton there, or threw him under the bus, whatever it is. He was the tour guide, and he's the guy who got to lead us on the equipment side a bit later in the week. You're all set, Doc. You can walk right through. A little bit later in the week, we've got the medical side with Pete Friesen and the training staff. That's fascinating as well. The equipment is state-of-the-art, and Pete is hands-on. The Hurricanes have come out hitting to protect home ice. We're scoreless in a slugfest so far with Ottawa.
Carolina Hurricanes hockey on Fox Sports Carolinas is brought to you by Kangaroo Express, your home for weekend discount Hurricanes ticket vouchers. Get right at the Roo. Beautiful look at the RBC Center as the Canes come home after a long road trip. It's important to start at home and set the tone and trip. They did so physically.
They needed this big line up front with three bodies in Ruutu, Staal, and Ponikarovski to finish hits. That's exactly what they did. Saw Ruutu first and then the captain, Erik Staal. Craig Anderson, he has a history of being good in this building. He was good in the first period. Here, a body save on Dwyer. Jeff Skinner leading the Hurricanes in points. Brandon Sutter, the good head of steam. Ponikarovski right off the bench on the feed from Harrison. And then Jussi Jokinen on Carolina's second power play. And Jussi thought he had drawn another one there.
We'll take a look back at the storm tracker from the top of the show, and we'll see how this played out.
Well, it's converting on the tracker without any results. You have to think it'll continue. No penalties taken against this red-hot Ottawa power play. Not even one Ottawa transition chance in a physical period from the Canes.
So we start the second period in high definition. John Forslund, Tripp Tracy, Bob Harwood, along with our fine crew here at the RBC Center. The Canes will stay home and take on Chicago Friday night. And on McCulloch off the side of the goal, we have word that Patrick Dwyer is on the ice and has returned after he was struck in the hand during the first period. Went off for attention. Good to see him back out there. In the middle of the ice now, Philip Kuba will clear it all the way back in the Canes zone. Brian Allen for Dwyer, negated by Kuba. Kalusti carries in with Sutter, broken up at the Senators' defense, and then transition back the other way. Jason Spezza tries to negotiate on Tim Gleason. Colin Greening for Ottawa keeps it deep. Brian Allen sealed off by Chris Neal. Greening now gets to it. Moved in back of the goal. Jason Spezza holding onto it. Up top for Chris Phillips, off a body, off to Lusty. Greening shot, blocked again by Brian Allen, and without his stick, Tim Gleason glides it back out to center.
And he didn't have a stick because his former Windsor teammate, I believe Spezza, was able to slash that out of his hands.
Sergei Gonchar this way for Chris Neal. A drop pass, he gets it back, it went off Zibanejad, and it was offside, captured by Chris Neal. The next Carolina Alehouse Cool Bars will be in Cary as the Canes take on the New Jersey Devils on November the 8th at 7:30. Log on to CarolinaHurricanes.com for more details.
Well, the young rookie Zibanejad will take this faceoff against Erik Staal, who had that great faceoff period one. One of the things, if he has to go back to the Swedish Elite League, that will be tough for his development, is it's such a bigger ice surface over there.
Right, the angles are different. There's so much different. They've assured him he'll be the Ottawa club. He's been assured by Jurgarten he'll play in all various capacities needed, power play and so on, but he may stick. Now McBain moved off for Ponikarovski, a one-timer denied by Anderson, getting to it. Yoni Pikkanen rolling it deep, broken up at the defense, and out they come. Chris Phillips, a spring pass for Nick Foligno. Foligno tries to make a move on Ponikarovski. Puck is there for the taking. Played by Zibanejad, dropped off for Kondra. Broken up here by Tuomo Ruutu, and out they go. Through the middle of the ice, Carlson denies Staal. Erik Karlsson, tripped up as Erik Kondra, sends Havitt. In control, Zach Smith. Good save by Cam Ward. Loose out in front, and the Canes get it out.
Well, the Hurricanes, for the first time in this game, had a chance to get a puck deep, and they didn't, and you see that transition game.
Now the puck goes deep. Zach Smith tied up by Chad LaRose. Erik Kondra for Ottawa goes deep. McBain looks around. Flushed out by Kaspar Zdogovins, and the puck comes back out to center ice. Over Carlson. Now it's a foot race. LaRose is on him. Chad LaRose gives Carlson a shove. Loose along the wall. Erik Kondra moved off for Zdogovins, and away they go. Here's Zach Smith, one on three. He'll fish it by the defense. Move it by Gaberle. Cutting across is Harrison, off a skate. Captured here by Jussi Jokinen, rubbed out by Jesse Winchester. Harrison spins it this way for Gaberle. Drop pass for Skinner, cutting. Jeff Skinner throws it across. Top of your screen, Thomas Gaberle overskated. He gets it back. He's knocked down by Zenon Konopka. Gaberle stays with it. Out of the pile, it's loose as we see. And wedge, but not out. Held in by Jussi Jokinen. It goes deep for Chad LaRose. Tied up by Chris Phillips. They come together in the corner, and you see it. Jokinen tries to dig it out. They continue that scrum. Jussi Jokinen with Zenon Konopka. Puck is loose. Rundblad has control for Ottawa. And the young Swede now carries ahead. David Rundblad through the middle. Lead pass over the line. The Sens are offside.
Well, we spoke about Jamie McBain in our pregame show and how he has, after missing the first three games as a healthy extra, has come in very well. Watch the middle of your screen, top of the screen. If he is not ready to shoot that puck doesn't get through. That Ottawa player gets in the shooting lane. That's being a step ahead of the play, and that's the difference. Whether it be a forward or a defenseman, you have that little hesitation, shots don't get through. Good play by McBain.
Cowan, through the middle now, goes across. Sergei Gonchar sends it deep. Colin Greening down the boards for Ottawa, pinched by Jared Cowan. Broken up by Brandon Sutter, and away we go. Brandon Sutter, head aside, Yuri Tulusti, denied at the D by McCulloch. Carried ahead by Dwyer, Sutter, off the stick off Cowan, loose out in front, hunted down by Tulusti. Now McCulloch, in the defensive zone for Ottawa, the former San Jose Shark. Sent across a couple of years ago in the Danny Heatley transaction. It goes deep. McCulloch now off the stick of Brian Allen. Allen knocks it down, tries to move it by Spezza. The Kings turn it over. McCulloch, and Cam Ward was ready for that. Now it's played off the boards and cleared out by Patrick Dwyer.
McCulloch, who's had such a strong start, has not had the ability to get to the paint. In basketball, that's right underneath the hoop. In hockey, that's the crease. That's where he's had his most success and even strength, and on the power play. Here Cam Ward, a nice square save, and he deflects the rebound out of harm's way after Spezza finishes the hit to help create the play.
Zibanejad for Carlson, the shot off the blocker of Cam Ward. Philip Kuba goes deep. Nick Foligno awaits the pass. Up top for Carlson, walking the line. Wristing one, swallowed by Cam Ward.
Well, Ottawa has, in the early going, won some big faceoffs, and there Zibanejad wins one, and it leads to a couple of good chances, and Cam Ward wisely takes a whistle. Let's take a look at Cam Ward and his body of work. Carlson, such a bright future. Began his NHL career, what a tutorship living with Ottawa captain Daniel Alfredson, who's expected back in the lineup on Thursday.
He broke in at 18, he's only 21. He played in the All-Star game here in Raleigh a season ago. Now back of the goal, Condra, Zach Smith with a shot, it goes high. And now Carlson at the point for Eric Condra. Condra, Kasper's Dogovins. Dogovins broken up by Pickenin, played by Stahl, not out. Smith cut it off the glove of Condra. Condra gets away from the man, sends it back for Philip Kuba. Kuba with a wrister through traffic, it goes wide. Now it's loose, out in front, forked wide by Dogovins. And now played by Zach Smith. Back to the point, Carlson loading the gun. Cam Ward said no, loose out in front, and it's covered up by number 30.
Boy, he does a job. The number 30 you mentioned of fighting through traffic. He doesn't let traffic drive his bus. And when I say that, he doesn't engage himself, and Dogovins here. You know, watch Cam Ward. You know, he doesn't try to throw him a shot. Good job there with the help of the defense. Podkorowski coming down low to help out, but then he just concerns himself with finding the puck. Well, contact there in the crease, and that's an interesting one when it comes to goaltender interference, because that's right close between whether it's in the crease or not, where incidental contact is not allowed, period, and then an opposing player can establish real estate.
Mika Zibanejad and Jussi Okunin in the circle. Carolina won 74% of their draws in the first period. And now the juice is given the boot. Chad LaRose won two faceoffs late in Winnipeg Saturday night. Control to Ottawa. Foligno. Nick Foligno out in front. Jussi Jokinen in control. And out they come. As you see, the Canes outfitted in their third jerseys tonight. They get it deep. And play is whistled dead. As the puck was batted down with a high stick.
That was a great job by Carolina. They're tying up sticks in the slot in their own end.
The Backyard Bistro is the place for Canes Corner, hosted by Mike Maniscalco from 99.9 FM The Fan. The next one is Wednesday, November 2nd at 7 o'clock. Jay Harrison will be the guest, and I'll tune in for that.
Yeah, he is always an interesting interview. Now, the Ottawa Senators have won the first six faceoffs of this second period, so Jokinen will want to stem that tide here.
Faceoff win by Foligno. Runblad forechecked by LaRose. Out of the corner scrum, it's kicked by LaRose. It pops out as we see, canceled by Phillips. Runblad, nice pass from Phillips. They escape harm and out they go. Chris Neal sidesteps Thomas Caberlet, and it comes all the way back. Harrison given a little bit of a bump from Zibanejad. Defending on a pass was Rundblad, and it comes back out. Here's the veteran, Chris Phillips. He'll send it all the way back. He was the first overall pick, Chris Phillips was, in 1996, as the play is whistled dead offside.
And if he stays healthy, he will play 1,000 games this year.
Yes, he will.
Played in Lethbridge in the Western Hockey League. And two of his teammates there became fine Hurricanes, Byron Ritchie and Shane Willis. Shane Willis, who is now working for the Carolina Hurricanes. They lost in the finals of the Memorial Cup in Hull, Quebec.
Shane is the director of youth and amateur hockey, taking the place of Paul Strand, who went on to coach college hockey in Alberta. Paul did a great job over the years here, cultivating that. Now it's in the hands, the capable hands of Shane Willis.
You have to love Lethbridge if you're a Hurricanes fan, because they are the Lethbridge Hurricanes.
There's a tie-in there, isn't there? The colors aren't the same.
No.
But the nickname is.
And the climate isn't the same either.
No, not at all. Now the puck is loose. We'll change the subject, thankfully. Out to center ice, Gonchar. Konopka with a shot. He scores! Zenon Konopka gets the goal, and Ottawa has a 1-0 lead.
And as we've mentioned, the Hurricanes have done really a good job of congesting the middle of the ice, and Ottawa has had really zero outnumbered rushes, and now they get one. So you see the pinch down low there by Jamie McBain. Sutter goes to seal a man, and so that really creates the outnumbered rush. Good puck movement. Boy, what a play by Gonchar. Takes the hit to make the play. It all starts with the pinch, and when you have the high forward, you really have to hang back, especially against a player like Gonchar. They can hit someone with that first pass, and Konopka does the rest with a good shot.
They got it going through the middle of the ice, and their fourth line center comes through. Zenon Konopka, his first goal of the season, 6:30 is the time of the second period. Shots are 17-11 Carolina, but Ottawa strikes first on that goal. Brandon Sutter given a bump by Colin Greening. Sergei Gonchar and Jesse Winchester get the assists on the goal. McCulloch overskated. Talusti has it for Carolina behind Patrick Dwyer. Moving up is Tim Gleason with an indirect pass. That comes all the way back. Now it's left to the corner. Played here by Philip Kuba off the stick of Zach Smith and corralled by Gleason. They go D to D. Allen through the middle. Wristed ahead. Carolina will go in a change as Lutu dumped it in. Kuba gets to it. Zach Smith has plenty of room to make a play, but he turns it over. Skinner, Stahl, hammers one, tipped out by Anderson on a deflection. Now Stahl in back of the goal, spins off Kuba. Eric Stahl for Jeff Skinner. Off a stick, broken up, collapsing all the way down. Kaspar's Dogovins, and out they go. Young Dogovins now will go deep. Harrison ahead of Smith, you see it. Now it's played by Rutu. Moved off here and wristed ahead by Skinner, but not out. Along the boards. Rutu engaged by Kondra, loose puck. Harrison out to center. The Canes over the line in the person of Jussi Jokinen. Now moving and turning is Skinner. Broken up by Rundblad. Worked ahead by Jokinen and back of the goal. Now they start again. Here's Rutu back to the point. Jay Harrison holding onto it. Across it goes. Kaberle, one-timer. Harrison off a body. Hit Kondra on the way through. Jokinen knocked down. Dogovins has it, and out they come. Eric Kondra. It's a three-on-one if they hurry. Kondra with a shot. It goes high. Now it's loose along the boards. Jussi Jokinen lead pass. Jeff Skinner. Zibanejad is back, and now Nick Foligno back the other way for Ottawa. Foligno moves it by LaRose. Gets to it. He'll cruise by Pickenin. Leave it there for Chris Neal. Neal holding. Moving away from McBain. Off the wall. On a cycle for Foligno. He's dogged by Pickenin. Now they take over again. Chris Neal out of the corner, holding onto that puck. He'll drop it off for Nick Foligno. Little stutter step on Pickenin. Foligno holding onto that puck. Up top it goes for Gonchar. He'll think about it. Foligno looks for a lane. Holding. Shooting one. Denied by Ward. They go for the rebound. They fight it off. Zibanejad's bid is blocked in front. Another chance for Ottawa. It comes back for Cowan. Good stick by Sutter, and it comes out to the center zone.
Key play, because speaking of sticks, Cam Ward did not have one, so that's a big clear by Sutter.
Cam Ward now leaves it for Jamie McBain. Just about halfway through on a goal by Zenon Konopka. Ottawa has a 1-0 lead through the middle. Pass intended for Dwyer. picked off by Winchester. Played at the Carolina defense. Turned out by Dwyer. Through the middle to Lusty. He'll dump it in. Craig Anderson out to play it. He'll leave it for Philip Kuba. Carolina goes to work in the forecheck. Panopka tied up by Stahl. They jam along the boards. It's poked out as we see, and Harrison is in control.
Hurricanes want to settle things down here. They didn't have any bad pinches in the first period. With a long second period change, you have to make sure if you're a defenseman, you have fresh bodies there to support.
Harrison, a bouncing shot kicked out by Anderson. Ona Karofsky, Stahl now takes over. Centers off the paddle of Anderson. As the Sens come back, Panopka tries to clear. Given a rough ride by Stahl. Stahl goes to work on Kuba. Eric Stahl now tries to will it out in front. He'll stay with it. The pass for Caberle. He's met by Panopka. Panopka plays it along the board. Stahl battle with Winchester. Kona Karofsky covering up at the point. Now it's Harrison. His shot blocked in front by Philip Kuba. And now Stefan DaCosta comes all the way down. He'll try and get it out. A chip by Winchester, and Ottawa will survive, and out they go. Winchester with Panopka holding, shooting one, denied by Ward. Loose out in front. Harrison back the other way as it's cleared out to center ice.
See, that's where you can't pinch because all three forwards were at the end of his shift. So Caberle, if he gets caught, you don't have the gas in the tank to make that a non-transition chance for Ottawa.
Rundblad. For Phillips, he gets it back. David Rundblad. Move away from Chad LaRose. Out to neutral ice. Nice move here. Rundblad over the line. Sets up Greening. Stopped by Ward. Moose out in front. Jokinen gets it ahead for LaRose. He has open ice. Chad LaRose over the line. You see it. Cutting with a shot. Fended off by Anderson. Out of the corner now. Colin Greening. Will start out for the Senators. 8:25 left to go in the second period. He dumps it in. This way it's Jason Spezza turning. Out in front. White blocked the pad that time of Cam Ward. Loose along the board. Now Greening again. Broken up by Boychuk. It's left there. Jason Spezza off a stick. Off Tim Brink. And again out to neutral ice. Gonchar ahead of Brett Sutter. Brett Sutter centers one off the paddle of Craig Anderson. And it's played here by Colin Greening. The ice was cut in half by Zach Boychuk, so he gets it deep. Ward plays it off. Brian Allen, a quick up for Zach Boychuk. Now broken up again at the Ottawa defense by Jared Callen. He'll send it in. Coming back is Tim Gleason. Boychuk by Dogovin's, a turnover. Hand on by Zach Smith. Now Callen fires wide of Cam Ward. Zach Smith again to the point. Gonchar along the wall getting to it. Here is Kondra. Denied by Brian Allen, and the Canes get it out to center ice. Brent on the wing. Kalusti, Dwyer cutting. Scooped up by Craig Anderson. 7:20 left to go in the second period. Zenon Panopka, one of the great names in the National Hockey League, has Ottawa's only goal so far. The scoring chances are mounting against Cam Ward. Ottawa, to their credit, they're working hard, they're getting the chances, and Ward is trying to keep it 1-0.
Well, this was, like I said, at the end of his shift. Stahl's line had been on the ice, and Caberle gets caught. Harrison, good job of taking away the pass, and Cam Ward makes a very fine save. Another chance here, good puck movement. There Cam gets across, and the key is he gets set on Greening. The Hurricanes want to get back to what was the style that they dictated in the first period, which was dominated by cycle play, not trading odd man rushing.
Rutu's shot absorbed on the way through. Coming up hard at him was Erik Karlsson. Now it's Nick Foligno. They stay onside. His shot! Ward said no. Swept out by Kona Karofsky, and getting to it is Stahl. Moved off for Jamie McBain. 13 minutes gone in the second period. John Forslin, Trip Tracy, Bob Harwood with you. First of two in a row at home this week. The Canes will host Chicago on Friday night. It starts with Hurricanes Live at 6:30. And then the Canes will be in Philadelphia on Saturday night. Eric Stahl moved off against Rioni, picking in. He'll go deep. Erik Karlsson comes off the forechecking pressure. Philip Kuba, quick up for Nick Foligno. Again out to the center zone. You see Jokinen off the stick of Tim Gleason, and all the Canes can do is just try and get it deep.
Well, Ottawa said they wanted to play a patient game. They haven't had success in this building, having not won for several years. They have been patient. They've been better this period.
Spezza gets room. Jason Spezza with a shot off the stick of Jussi Jokinen. McCulloch is taken down. Play continues. Now Gleason off the boards. Read by Phillips. Gloved again by LaRose. He's given a shove from Colin Greening. McCulloch looks for the puck. Turning is Phillips. Broken up by Gleason. And it comes all the way back in the Kane zone.
Not an easy thing to do as Jussi Jokinen just stayed with Jason Spezza. You would have thought for sure Cam Ward would have had to make a save. Good play by 36.
Chris Phillips on the wing. Contra over the line. His shot, no problem for Cam Ward. Loose this way. Played ahead by Patrick Dwyer. He'll move it by Runblad, who after it himself on Dogovins. Out of the corner now. A reverse by Runblad. Kaspar's Dogovins has control, and they move it off for Zach Smith. It comes all the way back. 5:22 on the clock. Brandon Sutter reorganizes. Canes start slowly again from their own zone. They can't mount any speed at all through the middle as it goes all the way in on Craig Anderson.
And the only way you usually can do that is by the forwards coming back with a purpose. That speed begins in their own end. So they come up as a group and push the other team back with that speed.
Caberle, center zone, picked off again by Ottawa. Right back in, Cam Ward. We'll leave it there for Jamie McBain. Forward line is Tim Brent, Brett Sutter, and Zach Boychuk. One option, slam it out to center ice. And it's picked off again by the Sens. Through the middle, Gonchar all the way in on Cam Ward. Yoni Pekkanen back for Carolina. McBain on the wall. Boychuk back to the point. Cowan, Jared Cowan, Jesse Winchester going wide off a stick off Brent. Picked off by Pekkanen. He'll move it along the boards. Winchester covering up. Arister goes wide. Loose this way for Jared Cowan. Cowan pickpocketed momentarily by Boychuk, and out they go. Yoni Pekkanen over the line. Brent for the front. Pekkanen holds, delays, shoots one. Off the body, off Gonchar. Loosen back now, and Milan McCulloch has it for Ottawa.
There's your speed, because every black jersey originated in the Carolina end. It had been a good Ottawa forecheck, but you can see when you all start in that defensive zone, that speed can come.
Colin Greening. McCulloch in back of Ward. Milan McCulloch holding onto it on the flank now. He gets it back, tries to walk it out in front. Denied, broken up. Here's Stahl. Eric Stahl through the middle. Steens by McCulloch. Comes in for a chance, throws on the brakes. Looks for a friend to pass to. Off a body, off McCulloch. Out of the corner, Ponikarovsky, Carlson are there. And now it's played by Kuba. Coming back is Greening. Off the window, he takes a hit and gets it out. 3:29 left to go in the second period. Shots are 21-16 Carolina. Now it's fed ahead by Tuomo Ruutu. Directing traffic is Craig Anderson. Ruutu says hello to Carlson. Now it's played by Chris Neal off a stick. Now to neutral ice. A loose puck, the Sens are after it, they get to it. And it's Chris Neal. A little bit of open space for him, he floats it off. Jay Harrison gets it back. Neal now in back of Ward, spins one off a stick. Foligno hits a hole ahead of LaRose. Nick Foligno battling along the boards, has the puck. Foligno again, off a couple of sticks, stays with it nicely. Here's Runblad, plenty of room, he walks in, delays. Sends it through the goal mouth. Now Phillips hammers one wide with a vacant net. And it comes back out to the center zone. Now they walk it in. Skinner tied up by Runblad. And Ottawa has control of that puck. And now they transition back out. Zibanejad plays it along the boards and deep.
How about Runblad there? The Hurricanes fans thought that he had taken a penalty. He jumps in, nearly sets up a goal, but then gets back. Former first-round pick by the St. Louis Blues.
Looking for his first NHL goal. Now Zach Smith over the line. Smith on Harrison. Walks in. Circles. He's knocked down. Harrison will go. Carolina will be shorthanded. We'll take a look at David Runblad, the young Swede. The kid is only 21. He almost makes it happen for his first NHL goal. Jay Harrison for hooking Ottawa to the power play for the first time tonight.
Let's watch and see where Harrison's stick gets parallel. It's on Smith. Boy, not much, but it happened just as Smith passed the goal line. You can see the referee far side of your screen, and this is the, in the young year, this is the second best road power play in the NHL. Jason Spezza told me this morning it's because of the net presence McCulloch, number nine, is creating in front, and the creativity up top by defenseman Sergei Gonchar, Eric Carlson.
Paul McLean's team is third overall, 9 power play goals and 31 chances on the young season. Carolina's penalty killing is number 21. Gonchar moved off for Carlson. Sergei Gonchar holding onto it, looking for a shooting lane. Jason Spezza loads the gun, blocked by Brian Allen. Colin Greening away from Tim Gleason. Jason Spezza from the boards, a pass that deflects, and it's poked ahead by Patrick Dwyer. Ottawa now reorganizes early in the power play. 1:35 left in it. Now it's carried by Carlson. Eric Carlson springs McCulloch. McCulloch now to the outside of Allen. Back to the point. Captured here by Greening. Now this is Sergei Gonchar. Turning off the wall is McCulloch. McCulloch back to the point. Gonchar again. Carlson stays patient. Guarded by Sutter. Gonchar with a wrister. Stopped by Ward. Loose. They score. Jason Spezza gets to it along the goal line. And Ottawa has a 2-0 lead.
Well, there's that net presence, and when you have that net presence, you just want to get pucks through. I think the guy that was creating it was not McCulloch, but it was Greening. Puck hit something on the way through, and Cam Ward did not know if he had it. Carlson creates a little space for Gonchar. Gonchar gets it to net quickly. Not sure if Greening gets a piece of that on the way in. The tip, it's actually his second jab. And it looked like the Canes may dodge a bullet. Gleason there with his second effort. Puck goes off the post. Spezza comes around the net with his reach and scores the goal.
Colin Greening and Sergei Gonchar get the assist. Power play goal, 18:36. Jason Spezza, fifth goal of the season. Spezza has points in four consecutive games. Kondra out to center ice. 2-0 Ottawa. 1-for-1 on the power play. Puck is loose along the boards. Stahl off a stick off Kondra. And now McBain retreats in his own zone. Under a minute left in period two. Rutu over the line. Dropping it off for Stahl. His shot. Kicked out with a purpose by Anderson. McBain a tough angle. Hit pinballs around. As Rutu was taken down, McBain one more time. Here's Joni Pikkanen. Slap pass. No option out in front. McBain again. Pikkanen holding. This way for McBain. 35 seconds left in the period. McBain with a shot off Dogovins. Now it's played here by Eric Carlson. Carlson walks it out of his own zone, cuts. Tries to get it over that blue line, they finally do, and now it's Eric Kondra. He'll throw it across on a change. Foligno, fresh body. Foligno cutting. His shot is blocked by Joni Pikkanen and corralled here and carried out by Jeff Skinner. Skinner denied at the D. A good play that time by Chris Phillips. Phillips reverses on Jussi Jokinen, but it's broken up by Skinner. The shot goes wide on a deflection. Cavalier plays it. Only 2 seconds left to go in the period, and two down here in Raleigh.
Well, Neil caught a high stick there, and the referees will get together now and see if anybody saw it. From a Hurricane standpoint, the Canes will hope that nobody did. Otherwise, Ottawa will get their second power play to start the third period.
Shots 22, Carolina, 17 taken by Ottawa. Zenon Konopka with his first, and Jason Spezza on the power play with his fifth goal of the season have made it 2-0 Ottawa after 40. Tim Brent will be Bob Harwood's guest right after this when we kick off the RBC Bank second intermission. Hockey Fights Cancer Night here in Raleigh as you take a look at the beautiful RBC Center. Hopefully the Canes have plenty of fight in this third period. Second period highlights. We'll take a look at the two goals, starting with Zenon Konopka.
Well, Ottawa did not have a transition game because of Carolina's position the first period, and they got it going in the second. Gonchar takes the hit from Sutter, finds Konopka, and Konopka finds some room on the short side. All of a sudden, it's 1-0 Ottawa.
Ottawa has a great power play. They've had only one power play chance tonight, and they cash in.
Well, Carlson did a good job just working down the half wall, found it to Gonchar, and Gonchar just, he sees he has traffic in front in the form of Greening, just gets it through, and sort of anonymously, Spezza comes around the net to tap in his fifth.
Zenon Konopka, goal number one, and for Jason Spezza, his fifth goal of the season for a surging power play. Now, Tripp, you're going to work with the telestrator.
Well, this is an adjustment. Carolina wants to get back to the first period. We're going to take a look at it here. You see all three players are below the dots. That means the defenseman doesn't want to pinch. McBain pinches. Now Sutter, who I think has really improved his skating ability, look, he gets back here. But because you have that lane completely open here, you don't want to go and finish a check, especially on a player that has the skill and the vision of Gonchar. Gonchar just leads Konopka, and he ends up scoring.
Rex Healthcare is teaming up with the Canes for Cancer Awareness Month. Submit your story, video, or a photo of how you or a loved one beat the odds, and you could win a pair of season tickets. Go to CarolinaHurricanes.com for more details. John Forslund, Tripp Tracy, along with Bob Harwood and our great crew. The two goal scorers tonight, Jason Spezza and Zenon Konopkin. Cam Ward doing his best right now. Ottawa with 18 shots. Carolina has had 22 at Craig Anderson, but the Sens turn the tables in that second period.
Yeah, I mean, the adjustment's very simple. Carolina plays the type of three-zone hockey they did in the first period. They're going to generate a lot of chances to climb this mountain. You just can't take those chances when the situation doesn't dictate like they did a few times in the second.
Third period in high definition on Fox Sports Carolinas. We're with you next. On Friday night here at the RBC Center, the Chicago Blackhawks in town. It will start with Hurricanes live at 6:30. And the Canes are in Philadelphia on Saturday night. You can see that one here, too. Ottawa goes home. They will take on the Florida Panthers on Thursday night. Now Gleason gets to it. He'll play it deep. Eric Staal goes over his stick, and now Erik Karlsson given a bump by Tuomo Ruutu. A loose puck steered along by Craig Anderson. Now Colin Greening tries to clear. Tim Gleason shot off Milan Mikolic, and it goes out of play.
Well, you see that a tweak has been made here. I believe Skinner is back, at least for now, with Staal. And so that's just a flip-flop, Ponikarovsky and Skinner, and we'll see what happens with that. No, I'm sorry, that was a partial line change, excuse me, as Skinner is on the left side here with his usual line mates, Jokinen and Leroux.
Off the faceoff. Skinner had it poked off of his stick, and now it's carried out by Nick Foligno. Chris Phillips through the middle. Broken up by Carolina's Joni Pekkanen. A move back paired with Jamie McBain on defense. As Chris pointed out, the Jokinen line is out for Paul Maurice. He's flanked by Chad LaRose and Jeff Skinner. Mika Zibanejad out in front, mopped up here by Ottawa's Chris Neal, and out they go. Through center, it goes by McBain. You see it come all the way back. Pekkanen's on the touch. Broken up here by Neal, who was caught napping. Neal now plays it along the boards. He'll go deep. Around the boards this way. Hustling across, Kaspar Stogovins tries to make a pass back to the point. Now the battle ensues, and it comes back for Karlsson. Philip Kuba goes wide. A wrister blocked in front by Joni Pekkanen. And Carolina now scoots back out to center ice. Patrick Dwyer, little dump and chase. Anderson paddles along this way. Along the wing, Dogovins tries to get it out. The young rookie brought up from the American Hockey League today, and now it's carried by Kondra. Kondra over the line, goes deep on Jiří Tulusi. Drops it off for Dogovins, back to the point, Karlsson. They go point to point, Kuba, high slot, Smith. Now Kondra, back for Karlsson. His shot blocked in front, Dogovins' turn, blocked again at the D by Caberle. Now Harrison in his own zone for Thomas Caberle, who hinges ahead. With a head of steam, it's Brandon Sutter. Sutter over the line, broken up by Karlsson. A good look at Colin Greening, who is checked on the play by Sutter. Back of the goal, they jockey for it. Greening in control. Carolina plays it in neutral ice.
Just goes to show, Dogovins, you mentioned, I think Zach Boychuk in limited duty. When you're playing a lot of hockey, as both players have been at the American League level and playing well, when you get right into the lineup, that's when you usually are most effective.
Mikolic moves up, drops it off for Spezza, out in front, nobody home. Greening will hunt it down for Ottawa. Jason Spezza tied up by Brian Allen. A loose puck in the corner, Tim Gleason on it for the Canes. He's dogged. Good play by Spezza, and it comes back out to center, and Mikolic goes deep. So the Canes now restart from their own zone. Through the middle now, goes behind Alexei Ponikarovsky. Chris Phillips, top of your screen, Tim Gleason. Ponikarovsky one more time, through the middle. Over the line, he hands it off to Tuomo Ruutu, and again they go deep. Ponikarovsky on the forecheck, Zenon Konopka coming back for Ottawa, and you see it float all the way back in Canes ice. Pekkanen ahead of Stefan DaCosta. A young man born and raised in Paris, France, played his college hockey at Merrimack in New England. Now it's Jussi Jokinen over the line. Dropping it off for Skinner. His shot blocked at the D. Rebound chance goes wide. It was Chad LaRose. After young Rundblad made a heck of a block on Skinner.
Boy, that's a great play by Jussi Jokinen. Just that little crossover, and he leaves it for Skinner. And that's a heck of a stick play to deny One heck of a scoring chance.
McBain drops it back. Yoni Pikkanen. Indirect pass. Looking for LaRose. It comes back. Jared Callen. Out to center ice. Foligno's after it. Sutter goes ahead. Callen is there. In the center zone now. The rolling puck is controlled by Jay Harrison. Chad LaRose. Brandon Sutter over the line. Goes wide of Callen. Dropping it back. Detected by Chris Neal. And he turns it over momentarily to Patrick Dwyer. Now the Canes will settle it down. Just about 5 minutes gone in period three. Carolina down by two. Moving up is Sutter. Moved off for Dwyer. Out in front. Out of the reach of Talusti. Up top it's Harrison. Inside he goes with it. Brandon Sutter this way. Plays it along the boards. Talusti looking for Dwyer. Picked off and carried out by Eric Condra. Condra now at the Carolina line. Nobody to pass to. Ottawa's changing, so he gets it deep.
Talusti had a good chance. He was well taken care of on the far post by Collin. And down two goals. You know the checking line of Sutter between Talusti and Dwyer will look to create offense himself.
Now Dogovins knocks one down. Gaspard's Dogovins for Route 2. Back to the point. Carlson, a shot taken off the blocker board. Played here by Zach Smith. Smith goes deep for Dogovins. Between the legs, attempts to set up Smith. Broken up by Harrison, but not out. Here's Philip Kuba. A wrister, pinballs wide. Loose this way. Carolina golfs it ahead. Ponikarovsky. Barutu looking for Stahl. Eric Stahl moving up on Philip Kuba. Stahl is knocked down by Kuba, who wedges that puck back out to center. Ryan Allen is there for Carolina. And Ponikarovsky turned it over. Condra off a stick. Spezza has it outside the line. And finally, it's controlled here off the bench by Milan McCulloch. McCulloch's in. Holding onto it. Spezza's shot blocked by Gleason as he fanned on it. Now Greening takes care of Gleason. McCulloch goes deep. Spezza curls off the board, holding onto it nicely. Jason Spezza with a shot. Off the side of the goal. Rebound loose. Cam Ward got across on McCulloch. Back to the point. Lundblad. A wrister. Stopped by Greening. Stopped by Ward. Now Greening turns. Holds onto it. Here's Jason Spezza. Faking now. His shot is blocked by Brian Allen. To the corner as it's all Ottawa. During this sequence, McCulloch goes after it. Back to the point. Phillips. He'll settle it down. Chris Phillips now goes deep. Back of Cam Ward. Colin Greening stays with it along the boards. He's bumped by Gleason. Colin Greening, good work for Ottawa. Sets up a man, Zibanejad, who fanned on it, and it kicks out.
Greening, a big part of the power play goal by the Senators. He is very tough to knock off the puck, isn't he? He reminds me a little bit of Backstrom in that capacity with Washington.
He's had a very solid game along the boards here tonight as Cowan goes D-to-D for Sergei Gonchar. Through the middle, fanning on that one was Chris Neal, and now getting to it is Jamie McBain. They'll move it off for Yoni Pikkanen. Through the middle, Brett Sutter. And again, Ottawa's been very good in the center zone as they pick off a loose puck. They've limited Carolina's speed, and they've picked off a lot of transitional passes. It comes all the way back. Pikkanen now to the corner. Here's McBain. Rink widening for Yoni Pikkanen. Through the middle again. Three defenders back, and they're offside. 12:45 left to go in this third period. Milan McCulloch picks up a loose puck. Cam Ward will come post to post and rob him.
It is Hockey Fights Cancer Month throughout the NHL, the month of October, a very special time to celebrate the game. You've noticed the lavender ties on the coaches and your fellow announcers. You see the pins as well on the lapels. The teams are getting involved in terms of decals on the helmets to get everybody aware, and the NHL is doing their part in a number of ways on a number of platforms. A real basic and traditional way is you can go to NHL.com and purchase Reflections 2011. It's a spectacular book of tremendous photos of players in action and in some cases away from the ice, and it really captures the emotions of the game. And when you tie it in, John, to the cause of helping beat cancer, this is a win-win situation.
So right, Bob, and that's a beautiful book. We're going to show you some photos at the next whistle. As Harrison now will steer it wide, great for the holidays, obviously, or any time, for a terrific cause. This initiative, over the years, 12 years running now with the NHL, the NHLPA, millions of dollars have been raised for a variety of cancer causes.
It's absolutely phenomenal. You think about Carolina, Pete Friesen, 5K here in Raleigh.
Yep. Cam Ward hangs onto that shot taken by Zach Smith, who has a disagreement with Yoni Pikkanen, and we'll take a look at some of those photos from Reflections 2011.
I don't think I've ever seen Burroughs with Vancouver jump so high.
That was game 7.
Yeah. And Eric Staal with some of his all-star footage. Jeff Skinner. Now you look at the Pete Friesen 5K. And also the Carolina owner Peter Karmanis and all the work he's done for the Karmanis Cancer Institute in Detroit over the years.
Fabulous. Cam Ward hangs on to that shot. We'll see Mr. Pete. Where is he? There he is, Pete Friesen, the outstanding strength and conditioning coach, head athletic therapist of the Canes. There's the title.
That's been a running charity event just in late August, early September every year. It has raised a ton of money, awareness, and it's been an ongoing thing. Good for Pete and the great, enthusiastic job that he's done for that prize.
1,200 runners this year as a penalty is called. Holding is the indication, and we'll see it with 11:46 left to go in this third period.
I think it's going to be an Ottawa penalty in the offensive zone, and this isn't. It's Zach Smith. This is the look on Paul McLean's face says it all. 2-0 lead for Smith in the offensive end, a long ways from home if home is the goal. And you can see that use of the free hand. So Carolina, that has not had a power play since their two in the first, this is obviously a big one here.
And Ottawa has had their issues shorthanded, as we pointed out earlier, under 70% as a team. Zach Smith for holding, 8:14 the time. Third power play for the Canes. They have had four shots with the previous two.
One thing Ottawa has done, and they did so there, is they've gotten better in the faceoff circle since Carolina dominated in the first.
Jussi Jokinen. Jamie McBain off the stick off Chris Phillips. Glove down by Staal. Swept out by Kuba. Held in by Pickenin. Now Skinner moved off for Jamie McBain. Inside it goes for the captain. Staal again for McBain. Eric Staal from the boards is peppered by Phillips. Turning with it is Skinner. Broken up by McCulloch. Off the linesman. Good break for Carolina. They can turn it right back in the zone. Yoni Pickenin will. As it's held up by Craig Anderson. Played for Chris Phillips. Up the gut and out. He'll kill some time.
That is the second key play Anderson, the goaltender, has made on dump-ins here in the third period. And the clear is important there because Ottawa is able to make a line change.
Through the middle, Condra. A lead pass looking for Dogovins. Coming across Skinner, broken up by Kaspers. Dogovins now. Condra, good save by Cam Ward. Overskating the rebound was Kaspers. Dogovins. Here comes Staal. Dogged from behind by Condra, who's been a great penalty killer for Ottawa this season. Even though they've struggled, they've pointed out that that will be his niche in the National Hockey League. And now it's cleared ahead by Caberle. It's knocked down, played here for the glove pass with 10:24 left to go in this third period.
Well, Ottawa has really employed the game plan that Paul McLean told us about this morning. And they've had a very tough time in the RBC Center. Very tough time. And he said the whole key was to be patient. And when you look back at it, Carolina had a big edge in the first period. They had to feel pretty good about the fact that it was 0-0. And then they started to play to their strengths. A transition goal and their power play scores on their first opportunity.
Teams will play next in Ottawa on November 27th. Here's Thomas Caberle. 27 seconds on the manpower advantage. He'll dump it in. They flood this side. Caberle at the point. Shooting one. Blocked on the way through. It went off Jesse Winchester, who has the puck. And again, he'll salt away more time. It comes all the way down to Cam Ward. Zach Smith will be back in 10 seconds. Kornikarovsky leaves it there. Condra does a good job. Now Dogovins cutting. Shooting one denied by Cam Ward. Now it's played by Thomas Caberle. Kornikarovsky through the middle. It deflects all the way back deep in the zone. This is icing on Carolina. The Hurricanes and Kangaroo Express have teamed up to offer discounted tickets to weekend games. Fans can save up to 67% for all Friday, Saturday, and Sunday games. Visit your local Kangaroo Express ATM and pick up a voucher good for any of the next four weekend games. You can also log on to CarolinaHurricanes.com for more details.
Good win there from Sutter on a rangy faceoff man and Spezza.
Puck is cleared in. Spezza in back of the goal, holding onto it. He has one of two Ottawa goals tonight. Jason Spezza centers one off a body, blocked by Caberle. He goes after it again. McCulloch at his side. Milan McCulloch cruising the line is Sergei Gonchar. Gonchar off a stick off Kornikarovsky, and it goes out of play. 9:14 left to go in this third period. Craig Anderson checks out the clock. He likes what he sees. 2-0 Ottawa. The World Hockey Championships can be a wonderful experience, and these two share that bond.
Yeah, they were roommates, Jason Spezza and Jeff Skinner, and Spezza told me this morning that Jeff Skinner is as good of a person as he's met in hockey. They also train with a skills coach in suburban Toronto named Yari Burski before the start of every training camp. Spezza's eyes just lit right up when he started talking about Jeff Skinner and how much he's enjoyed getting to know the young Carolina Phenom.
Finland took home the gold. Tuomo Ruutu part of that team. Off the faceoff, it's cleared around the wall. Played here by Ponikarovsky and again out to center ice. Alexei Ponikarovsky with Brandon Sutter and Patrick Dwyer. Ponikarovsky with a backhander easily denied by Craig Anderson. Moving up here is Brian Allen. Brandon Sutter turns, shoots one, swallowed again. No rebound given up by Craig Anderson.
I would have to say Paul Maurice has been quite patient here with his line combinations and has now decided to throw a few wrinkles into it. And Anderson has shown he's going to stop what he's going to see. First man pursuit by Ponikarovsky. Good pinch there from Allen. See, that's a good pinch because you had the relief from Sutter. You know, the Hurricanes have gotten back to those good pinches in the third.
Pickenin with a shot taken, picked off again by Craig Anderson. Little net front presence from Tuomo Ruutu, but Anderson saw it.
Well, you win a faceoff, you can make a play. And I said Anderson has had a good success in this building. I mean, he's the guy that came in relief of Thomas Volkoon in that game 82 that Florida spoiled Carolina's playoff hopes a few years ago.
Ottawa got possession and, as we see, lost it. 8:42 left to go in this third period. The Canes down by two. Ottawa has won two games in a row. A miraculous win over Columbus on Saturday night with less than a minute to go as they come back, tie it, and win it in regulation. Grunblad will clear it ahead. Before that, they defeated Winnipeg. Now it's played here by Yoni Pikkanen. Carolina will see Chicago here Friday, in Philadelphia Saturday. It's broken up by Chris Phillips. Nick Foligno back to get it. Let's settle it down. Both teams are changing. Foligno through the neutral zone, off the glass and deep. It's picked up by Jussi Jokinen. He'll push ahead. Jokinen through the middle. Here's Skinner over the line. Cutting. No quarter given by Sergei Gonchar. Now the Senators back with Kondra. Eric Kondra from well out. Caught and hung on to by Cam Ward.
John, we'll take a look at some of Eric Staal's work. You remember back to our pregame show, and Paul Maurice said when things are not going well for Eric Staal, it's never a lack of effort. He came out his first shift. He was very physical. Phillips has had the task of dealing with Staal all night long, and we're starting to see some line changes now. I think the drive and that work ethic has been there with Ponikarovsky, Ruutu, and Staal. They just don't seem to have the ability to support one another, and you're not seeing all three bodies there and outnumbering pucks and being able to create anything off of it. It just seems like they haven't been able to read off of one another like they'd like to.
And that's why we started the show tonight talking about that. And it's a catch-22. You got to give it some time, but then you have to, at some point, go in another direction. And it's not easy because it alters everything else that's going on.
Yeah, it does. And I thought they've had a couple of good shifts. They had one in the second period, I remember. But it's just a work in progress.
Mm-hmm.
It's tough because nobody cares more than Eric Staal about getting this thing righted for him.
Now Anderson. Played along the boards. LaRose is there, blocked by DaCosta. Where is it? I believe DaCosta has it somewhere as part of his personal belongings. That was quite neat. Now, be the first 10,000 fans through the door. Get your Jeff Skinner bobblehead on November the 14th when the Canes take on the Philadelphia Flyers at 7. Log on to CarolinaHurricanes.com or call 866-NHL-CANES or visit Ticketmaster.com.
Yeah, there's a big faceoff setter against Konopka. Konopka scored the first goal, has always been a faceoff specialist, takes great pride in it.
Smith.
They're taking the draw.
Dogovin's back out through center ice, off Gleason. Ian Pikkanen on defense. The forward line is Brandon Sutter, Alexei Ponikarovsky, and Patrick Dwyer. 13 minutes gone in this third period. Canes coming home from a four-game road swing. They went 2-1-1 as that play is whistled dead offside.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of people are asking And I hesitate bringing it up, but the proverbial first game back after a road trip, and I don't know why it is. You know, it's tough to talk about it here still in the first month of the season, but players haven't slept in their own beds for quite some time. Players that have families haven't seen their kids. So there's a readjustment period, and maybe that points to why the Hurricanes aren't the only team that seem to have trouble with that first game back.
6:50 left to go in this third period. Down 2-0 to the Ottawa Senators. And the Hurricanes start a sequence of games here where they're going to have to make sure they make good on all of it. 7 of their next 10 at home. Now it comes deep, and icing is called.
Good play by Pittman to get back to that puck. McCall skates very well for a big man, doesn't he?
Oh, he's fast.
He is a fast player. This Ottawa team's been impressive. I mean, in a place like Canada's capital, anywhere in Canada where there's so much pressure, I would argue that this Ottawa team, because of what they've committed to in their youth movement, is playing with less pressure than they have in many, many years, and that can be a good thing.
Well, they told the fans, this is what we're going to do. And for the most part, from what I've heard, the people have bought in Ottawa. And they recognize there'll be challenges. And they got off to a really poor start. But now they're looking at possibly winning 3 in a row, unless Carolina, who still has time. There's 6:19 left. There's still time to come back. Caberle now moved off out in front. A loose puck. Ottawa plays it well. They have been positionally sound in front of Craig Anderson, and it comes back.
And they've been especially good in their own end, whether it be bodies or blocking shots or getting sticks on pucks. Getting any kind of clean look with the puck on the tape in that slot area has been difficult.
Skinner. Canes again offside. We're going down the stretch here at the RBC Center. 5:54 left to go in period 3. Goaltender's job, keep the team in a position to come back and possibly tie a game. Ward has done that tonight for the Hurricanes. Jason Spezza, we talked about him becoming a burgeoning leader. That's been on display. Their captain, Daniel Alfredson, sitting this one out with a hip injury. And Craig Anderson, 25 saves. And when Carolina was at their best in the first period, he was very strong.
Well, and that's been the one thing that has really hurt Ottawa this year, whether it be Anderson or all. They've given up the soft goal at the tough time, and he's been really good tonight.
Coming back now, UC Jokinen. We'll throw it deep for Carolina. Chris Phillips finished off by Chad LaRose. Nick Foligno, simple play, and that's what they'll do. Chip pucks back out to center as they protect the two-goal lead. Yoni Pikkanen now going deep. From ice level, Foligno ahead of Pikkanen. Out of the corner now. Zibanejad, Mika Zibanejad, a soft clear. Shot taken by Skinner wide of Anderson. Centered off Anderson. He senses a bit of trouble, so he melts it down. Let's take a look at Craig Anderson and what he has done tonight.
Well, I think the biggest thing that he's done is he's utilized his size. Look at these body saves in the first period. Good save. Another one. Actually sees through his own man. I think that's Khalid Kuba. There haven't been a lot of second opportunities. So he's searching for a shutout. Speaking of which, I hear Jonathan Quick. 3 straight shutouts will get the night off.
Yep. Terry Murray said the plan all along was to play Jonathan Bernier in this game tonight against the Devils. So the shutout streak, it'll wait. 3 in a row. First star this week in the National Hockey League. 2 goalies part of the mix as far as that is concerned. Thomas Volkoon of Washington, 3rd star. And Jason Spezza here tonight, star number 2.
The guy with a huge shutout record in terms of the streak.
And a goal! Carolina gets a loose puck and a little bit of life. It's Tuomo Ruutu. Under 5 minutes remaining, and the Canes break the shutout of Craig Anderson.
We just jinxed the shutout, didn't we? We mentioned shutout 3 or 4 times, and Tuomo Ruutu gets Carolina on the board. This is just, you know what? This is being able to get to the front of the net. It's sort of a unique type play, but in a way that Carolina has not been able to. That's Yuri Talusti that I think causes a lot of that. Because he drives the net, he draws the attention of both Ottawa back checkers, and Rutu's there as a follow-up, and he's able to loft the puck. And it may have gone off the short side post and in. The Canes have life.
Well, Sergei Gonchar, for some reason, decided to go up the middle with it, and a soft clear is capitalized on by Tuomo Ruutu. Yuri Tavusti did force the issue, but there's no excuse for Gonchar there. Good fortune for Ruutu, and the Canes now have an opening. 4:39 left in regulation time. A loose puck as we see in the Carolina zone. Jay Harrison gets the assist on Ruutu's third at 15:08. Now it comes back deep in the Canes zone. Spezza going hard at Pickenham. Down the wall is Dwyer. McCulloch cuts it off. Ponikarovsky off the boards for Sutter. Now it's played by Philip Kuba. Off the stick of Patrick Dwyer. And now in control is Jason Spezza. All the way across for Erik Karlsson. Nice move on Pickenham. He'll walk it in the zone. He's defended by Ponikarovsky. They jam along the wall. Peppering it is Pickenham. And now it's carried by Foligno. And taking him down the stall. And he'll do it himself. Erik Staal. Out to center for Dwyer. He goes off on a change. He gets it deep. Under 4 minutes left in regulation time. Rundblad, the young defenseman for Zibanejad. Mika Zibanejad over the line. Moved off for Foligno. Out in front, off the skate of Zibanejad. Carolina, transition time. Here comes Caberle. Over the line with Staal. And McBain, Caberle shot. Picked off by Anderson.
Boy, Caberle tried to get the goaltender leaning off the short side post and go to the same area that Ruutu did. And Anderson didn't bite. We'll take one more look at the goal. Well, just a stretch breakout. I don't know if Staal gets a piece of it or not. And you're right. I mean, that's one of those plays where I just don't know why Gonchar didn't play it. He just let up on it. You had Cowan there too, and the Canes drove the net. And they just had another great chance. Caberle was denied by the Anderson snare.
Jussi Jokinen kicked out of the faceoff. LaRose now against Zach Smith. They square up. Visitor down first. There it is. Off the draw. Ottawa in control. Off McBain. Cleared ahead by Gogovins. Looking for Smith. Carolina's on it. Caberle now in his own territory. 3:23 left in this third period. Carolina down by one. McBain looking for LaRose. Swept ahead by Phillips, and you see it come back.
And one other quick thing about that goal is Anderson must have thought it was going to be icing, because otherwise he would have played it with his stick as it came off the end boards. It was well within his reach.
There was a ball of confusion, no doubt. Now it's played ahead by Jokinen. Over the line, Skinner. Whirling puck, LaRose. LaRose by Rundblad. Here's Caberle. Centering one across. Chopped at. Blocked in front by Rundblad. Phillips. He's hard-pressed by good forechecking. Jokinen back to the point. Harrison. Now the juice. Jussi Jokinen, Jay Harrison. Wristing one. Swallowed by Anderson. And a penalty. A penalty out in front. Holding is the indication. Ottawa will go down a man, I believe. And a great break for Carolina.
Is it Mr. I like to go to the dirty area, Skinner, that draws this penalty? Take a look at the save. Anderson gets a clean look at it. That's the key. But I think Skinner is drawing the penalty in front. Well, Jeff Skinner has made a living and has put himself in a gigantic way on the map in this league, because he goes to those nasty areas as a small player. I think it's Rundblad that takes the penalty for the hold. Nobody is in the box as of yet.
Paul McLean wants his troops over now. And he's going to tell them, hey, we played hard for so long, and now this. And their penalty killing has been an Achilles heel all season. Carolina has called the timeout to organize the power play. The Chicago Blackhawks are coming to town Friday at 7. It's family night here at the RBC Center. That means $1 hot dogs for all night long for everyone in attendance. Purchase tickets by visiting the Time Warner Cable box office, calling 866-NHL-CANES, or go to Ticketmaster.com.
Well, there are a couple things here, John, to think about. 2:37 left on the clock. Ottawa can obviously ice the puck for free. Ottawa, on their power play goal, had Greening in front, a net presence. Carolina had two guys driving the net, Tavusti and Ruutu, on the goal that has made this a true hockey game. So how early will Cam Ward be lifted? You got to get to the front of the net.
We'll keep an eye on him. Here's McBain, wristing one. They score! It deflects on the way through, and Carolina has tied it.
What a face-off win. And you have a guy going to the front of the net. And Anderson thinks what is going to be a routine shot. I believe hits a stick, and all of a sudden the puck squibbles through. This is eerily similar to Ottawa's goal on the power play by Spezza, because McBain does a great job just wristing it to the front of the net. And it's tough to tell with Definity if Skinner gets a piece, but his reaction would certainly tell you that he did.
Well, somebody did. It could be Skinner. If it goes off the Ottawa player, it's McBain. It's tipped twice, and I think it might maybe Jeff Skinner, but we'll wait for the official word.
How about the footage that we showed the first period? Brendan Moore working with the centerman yesterday. Ottawa had a good faceoff success rate the second period, but first and third, it has been all Carolina. That does not happen if Staal does not win that draw cleanly. What a job by McBain. Take a step and just get it to the net however you can with the wrist shot. Jeff Skinner once again. He draws the penalty, going to the dirty area. Kane score the goal, him going to the dirty area.
Let's go down to Bob Harwood, who has a note on Jamie McBain.
Well, Johnny, there's a reason we talked about him and with him in Hurricanes Live and in the open of our show. He's kept his game simple, and he's developed confidence that way. I was wondering as he was saying it to me, I'm trying to simplify. I'm not trying to do things too fancy and complicated. Exactly what he meant. That was a great example of a basic decision where he didn't gamble, and he kept the puck alive, and it was a threat.
You know, Bob, you're absolutely right. And I will tell you, I believe that this goal is being reviewed. And I think the only reason is, if it goes off Skinner's body, is there any intent? I can't see any reason that this isn't going to be a good goal.
It goes off his glove hand directed in, that would be the only issue here. And that's what they need to find out, because the call on the ice is goal. They have to have conclusive evidence if it is directed in with a hand by Skinner, if that's the case.
And obviously, I can't even tell with absolute certainty if Skinner touched it. Okay. And so in the call on the ice, you have to have overwhelming evidence. I think that this will definitely be a goal. Staal get a piece. Boy, Staal's stick was in that lane too, wasn't it?
There were sticks everywhere. Both sides. And at this point, it really doesn't matter, but it will be Jeff Skinner's goal from Jamie McBain and Eric Staal at 17:29. And for Mr. Skinner, that is goal number four. 2-2 game, 2:22 on the clock. As the Senators go deep, Brian Allen for Tim Gleason. Brandon Sutter. At the skate boot of Alexei Ponikarovsky, it comes back. Ponikarovsky's on it, holding onto it. Wrap chance denied by Anderson. Gleason tipped out in front, and it's broken up. And the Senators retreat. Jason Spezza, Philip Kuba, McCulloch over the line, and it's offside.
Boy, isn't it funny how the world of hockey works? Ottawa is down a goal in the last minute against Columbus on Saturday. They win the game in regulation. Carolina has nothing going. Innocent play, Ruutu with Tolusti in front, gives Carolina life. And once again, Jeff Skinner, to me, that's leadership at 19 years old by drawing the penalty and being there in front on the tying goal.
Puck comes back now for Phillips, who dumps it in. Kondra lays it off for Zach Smith. Staal coming back. Dogovins with a shot to Kyle over the top of Cam Ward. Rundblad at the point. Inside it goes for Eric Kondra. Pops out as we see. McBain's on it. 1:37 left in regulation time. Tolusti for Ruutu. Staal's the trailer. Eric Staal with a shot. Locked. It's loose. Broken up by Kondra, who's dogged by Staal. And they get it out. Zach Smith now knocked down by McBain. Turned ahead by Tolusti. A loose puck. Ottawa's on it. Kondra off on a change. It goes deep. 1:17 left. Brand new game here. As the Canes come back from two goals down. Out to center ice. Jussi Jokinen lays it off. Shot taken by Skinner is blocked on the way through. Gonchar. Back out to center. Under a minute left. Greening. Spezza. Greening for the front. Jason Spezza shoots one. Camboard says no. And he hangs on.
What a phenomenal save. You know, we spent a lot of this year talking about the Hurricanes and their exemplary work blocking shots. But something that you have to be careful of, especially against a guy like Spezza, don't leave your feet at the wrong time. Very difficult proposition for Brian Allen. And wow, what a job waiting out Allen by Spezza, and Cam Ward, his biggest stop by far of the night.
Zibanejad off the draw. 49 seconds left. Carlson goes deep. Neal, Allen, a loose puck. Chris Neal for Ottawa. Philip Kuba outside the blue line. They're offside. They have to tag up. 37 seconds on the clock. Here's Brandon Sutter racing out the center ice. Over the line. He tries to make it happen. It's broken up. And now Spezza hammers one off the boards. He broke his stick in two. Loose puck. Spezza gloves it ahead. 19 seconds left. Here's Neal. Ryan Allen breaks it up. Ponikarovsky through the middle. Alexei Ponikarovsky broken up by Chris Neal, who slides it back in Kane's ice. 7 seconds on the clock. It looked like this game was for naught as far as Carolina was concerned. They come back with two goals and earn 1 point in the standings as we go to overtime.
Well, the Hurricanes play through the final buzzer. They didn't have much going. Ottawa had some confusion on the first goal. But to me, on both goals, Carolina finally got to the boardwalk in Park Place District. Ruutu and Talusti on Tuomo's goal, and then Skinner off of the stall draw in the second.
Third period, comeback for the Canes, and we'll take a look at how it transpired.
Well, I give a lot of credit to Yuri Tulla. That's a nice angle from the truck. I don't think we had seen that one. A good job of elevating that puck from Tuomo. Now that's a little line change, put Talusti up on that top line. And now after Skinner draws a penalty, Stahl wins a draw. Then Stahl has the first layer of a possible tip and Skinner right in front. And the puck just squibbles through. And the Canes have gotten a point that a lot of people probably didn't think they'd get.
The Texas Rangers won a thrilling game to take a 3-2 lead in the series. And tomorrow night they'll be in St. Louis when they take the field with a chance to clinch their first championship in franchise history. Legends are born in October, and Game 6 of the World Series between the Rangers and the Cardinals begins tomorrow at 7:30 only on Fox.
I liken this 4-on-4 overtime situation. Paul Maurice working with Dave Lewis, and they're talking about their combinations right now. I like when Pitkinen and Jokinen are used together, and they were in the first shift of overtime Friday in St. Louis, and it led to that first pass that Joni and Juuse try to work usually on the power play, and it led to a power play in overtime. So I like the two of them being paired together 4-on-4.
The guys in black have new life, and the guys in white are being tested. A young hockey club and a goaltender who had a shutout going late. That's gone away. Now we go to 4-on-4 hockey. Each team has secured 1 point in the standings. Carolina now with 9 and Ottawa with 7. Take a look at the overtime records. A face-off, that's controlled back. A false start, they'll do it again.
And of course, the other big bullet point of the third period was the Cam Ward save on Spezza after this building came to life with the tying tally.
Well, that was the big moment for Ward, there's no question. He's made a few of those here tonight, but certainly in regulation, with that kind of room and that kind of a shooter, a tremendous save. McBain and Pickett in on defense. Up front, Juuse Jokinen and Erik Staal for Carolina. Through the wickets of Jason Spezza, comes all the way back. Philip Kuba moved off for Colin Greening. Underneath it is Spezza, and away they go. He has Carlson at his side. Erik Carlson darting. Jason Spezza delays. Good play by Jamie McBain. Now it's played by Colin Greening. McBain stays with it nicely. And now it's Staal. Again for Joni Pekkanen, and away they go. Juuse Jokinen to the outside. Pekkanen moves up. Holds, centers one across. Staal now. Centers off a body off Greening, a loose puck. Erik Karlsson's on it for Ottawa. Just about a minute gone here in overtime. Now the young defenseman plays it off with streaking Milan McCulloch. McCulloch now cutting here, broken up by Sutter. Brandon Sutter has room. He'll start. He's out there with Jeff Skinner, Jay Harrison, Thomas Kaberle. Harrison with a shot, fought off by Anderson. Played now by Zibanejad. Broken up by Skinner. Jeff Skinner leaves it there. Mika Zibanejad is on it. A lead pass for Chris Phillips, dodged by Sutter. And Ottawa's offside.
Well, we spoke in our pregame show about the maturation of Jamie McBain. In overtimes, he's had ice in his veins, hasn't he? From his first career goal in overtime against Pittsburgh. to an overtime goal against Buffalo last year. Great defensive play, and then Harrison's smart shot. Put that in an area that maybe Brandon Sutter can get to it, but McBain had made a great stick play in his own end.
Faceoff comes back for Jared Callen. Flushed out by Chad LaRose. Picking him down the wall. Gonchar got it out. Arutu is there. He goes across for Tim Gleason. It's a bouncing puck. We'll have to settle it down this way. It's Joni Pikkanen. Through the middle of the ice, Chad LaRose at his side, Tuomo Arutu. Here comes LaRose. He'll make a move. Shot taken, stopped by Anderson. And no further play.
Good job coming up the ice as a group. Timmy Gleason has the history of playing with Joni Pitkin to begin the season and also on the right side. They're on this shift here in overtime. Good support position by LaRose and good support from Rutu. And all of a sudden, you gain the line with speed. Rutu drives the net. That creates the shooting lane, and LaRose challenges Anderson high.
Stahl, Jokinen, Gleason, and Pikkanen for Paul Maurice. The juice for Joni Pikkanen along the boards. Moving on Philip Kuba. He retreats, plays it inside the line, keeps it deep. Stahl awaits the pass. Eric Stahl in back of Anderson. Tries to utilize his frame to protect the puck. Work it down the wall, broken up by Erik Karlsson. Stahl goes at him. Greening's after, top of your screen, Gleason. Stahl has Jokinen out in front. Erik Stahl separated from the puck. Jokinen is there. Now Pikkanen awaits. Joni Pikkanen downstairs to Stahl. Stahl to the outside off the stick of Kuba. Moving down the boards is Jussi Jokinen. Loose in the corner. Getting to it is Joni Pikkanen by Spezza. Turned ahead by Erik Karlsson. Karlsson from his own zone. 2:32 left in overtime. Both teams are changing. Carlson now senses that. Lays it back for Rundblad. And away they go. Pass now for DaCosta. His shot. Good save by Ward. Rebound for Carlson. It's blocked by Sutter. A loose puck. Carolina. Back the other way. It's Skinner. Skinner approaches. Foligno takes a whack at it. Gets it deep. Anderson leads it there for Rundblad. He'll play it off now for Carlson. Calmly through center. Nick Foligno. Muscled a bit by Jay Harrison. Stefan DaCosta out of the corner. Jamie McBain is on him. And it's dug out by the combination of Skinner and the guy with the puck now, Brandon Sutter. Sutter out to center ice by McCulloch. Walks in for a chance. It's blocked. It's loose. Skinner hooked a bit. Skinner stays with it. He centers one. Off Phillips. Well, the magic of Skinner almost worked again. And now it's played here by Phillips.
Well, the bottom of the ninth inning with the World Series going on, that's clearly when Jeff Skinner shines most.
McCulloch walks in, delays, sends it, and it's broken up by LaRose. Here come the Canes out to center ice. Tuomo Arutu walks in, goes to the outside of Gonchar, button hooks, lays it off for Pickett and holding, shooting one. Oh, Anderson got a piece. Now it's Gleason. Gleason holding onto that puck, delaying. He'll load the gun, fake again, shoot one, stop, covered, loose, rebound, stopped again by Anderson. Oh, mercy, LaRose had a dandy. Now it's Pikkanen, Pikkanen along the wall, back for Gleason, under a minute left in overtime. Gleason holding onto it, looking for a lane, faking, delaying, shooting one, blocked by Zibanejad, getting to it, Pikkanen, cruising deep in the zone, Joni Pikkanen down the wall, in back of Anderson. Pikkanen now circles the wagons, holds onto that puck. He'll cruise all the way back to the other side. It's a one-man show. Now out of the corner. Here's Rutu. Tuomo Rutu. Here's a chance. Gleason holding. Shooting one. Blocked in front. Loose for the taking. Gathered in by McCulloch, who sends it back. 25 seconds left in overtime. Everybody out of gas. With the puck is Gonchar. Fresh bodies over the wall for both teams. Out of the corner, Carlson. He'll scamper away. Eric Carlson out to center ice. Over the line, shooting one high. Over the top of Cam Ward. 10 seconds on the clock. Here comes the captain. Stahl over the line, pulls up. He'll delay. Pass one in front. What a save by Anderson on Harrison. And Ottawa survives at the horn.
What an overtime. All Carolina. They came in waves. It started with Skinner here on Rundblad, fights around him, and then goes for that patented stuff that he's been so successful at trying to find Sutter. Hurricanes make a line change. Nothing changes. They continue to attack. Sutter and LaRose, Gleason and Pitkin were dynamite up top, and then Stahl sets up Harrison. Erik Stahl was a different player in the last 5 minutes of regulation of this game and then overtime. Boy, Anderson was just stellar.
Oxygen, baby. Oxygen. Everybody take a break. Guess what? The shootout when we come back. Deadlocked at two here in Raleigh. We're back here in Raleigh. Eric Staal and his teammates, Brian Boucher, the backup goaltender, take a break here. The shootout awaits. What a finish.
Just awesome.
We'll take a look at the Storm Tracker tonight, Tripp, our new feature. Three keys for the game, and they've held up.
Yeah, I would have to say that they have. I mean, Ottawa scores on their only power play, showing how lethal it is, but Carolina gets a tying goal on a power play. And the only time that Ottawa had their transition game going was in the second period, and the Canes have had a slight edge in physicality. And whatever happens here in this shootout, Eric Staal has been a man possessed here. Like I said, late regulation in overtime.
Jeff Skinner with a tying goal. The play was reviewed, and we thank the National Hockey League for the confirmation from the situation room. They were taking a look at whether or not the stick was above crossbar level. That was the official word on that as far as Skinner tipping that shot taken by Jamie McBain in, which tied the game at 17:29 of the third period.
Thank you to the war room for that. And Anderson, the Canes, I'm trying to remember if they've had any shootouts against him when he was a Florida Panther. He's had one this season. I think scoring the first goal in the shootout is so important. You know Skinner will go first, Jokinen will go second. It'll be a question of who goes third.
The reigning Calder Trophy winner, Jeff Skinner, against a goaltender that was given Vezina consideration 2 years ago. And 40%, like everything else he does, is not too shabby. So 19-year-old Jeff Skinner will start it off for Carolina as we go to the shootout. Skinner now swooping in on Craig Anderson. And he's denied.
Now he tried to go five-hole between the legs of Anderson. And Anderson just outweighed it. Let's see how much room was there. Yeah, that's the old lure technique. There was some room there. Skinner may have just missed his spot.
Cam Ward, his acumen in shootouts. And Milan McCulloch will be shooter number one. Tied for third in terms of goals so far in the young season. McCulloch on Cam Ward on the Ottawa side in the shootout. Cam Ward says no.
Real aggressive stick there. It was almost like a half poke check on the part of Ward. He really challenged the shot, if you will, with that stick. And I think he did so. McCulloch's head was down. There's no way he could have seen that stick coming. And he had the pad there to back it up. Here's the specialist.
You see Jokinen, since the dawning of this situation, the shootout at the end of the NHL lockout, the 2005-06 season, he has been one of the best at it. And Paul Maurice loves to use him in the two-hole. So the juice for Carolina. Shooter number two on Craig Anderson. Jokinen stutter steps, and he's denied.
He likes to use him in the two-hole because Jussi likes it so he can see what the goalie does on the first shot. And there he actually went back to probably the move that he's had the most success with. A little stutter step to try to get the goalie to bite and then go to that blocker side. What a patient save by Anderson.
Jason Spezza, who scored Ottawa's second goal tonight.
Second shooter for Ottawa, 19.
12 out of
Jason
34
Spezza
in his career. A stare down with Cam Ward. Spezza, who's shown leadership for his team tonight, scores. Jason Spezza makes it 1-0 Ottawa.
Between the legs, and you know, it looked like he caught Cam Ward trying to figure out if he was going to stay up or go down. Doesn't come in with a ton of speed. You can almost feel it. You know, like Cam was trying to decide, where should I go down to the butterfly or should I stay up? And that's a sniper's goal by a sniper.
Well, it's up to Tuomo Ruutu, whose goal gave Carolina a breath of life in this game. They were down 2-0 when he scored, and now they need this one. Ruutu walks in on Anderson. And Anderson makes the save, and Ottawa wins the shootout.
Well, Anderson may have won the shootout, but he really won the game for Ottawa in overtime when it was all Carolina. Ruutu came in, and you know, he almost ran out of speed. And at that point, Anderson had to know that he had him as Tuomo went to the backhand. And the goaltender was just able to move over, get square, and there just wasn't anything to shoot at. Hurricanes, based on the way they played in period four, will definitely be upset that they didn't get the extra point. When the dust settles, They'll be proud of the fact that they fought late to get one. See, he just ran out of speed. And Anderson was very, very patient on Skinner, Jokinen, and Ruutu. A goalie never wants to make the first move, and he didn't.
Craig Anderson staying right with Tuomo Ruutu.
Yeah, he just outweighed it.
Yep.
That's...
Final count in the shootout. Ottawa 3 and Carolina 2. Our next telecast will be Friday night here at the RBC Center. The Chicago Blackhawks are in town. We'll start with Hurricanes Live at 6:30. Hurricanes Live, the post-game edition from the RBC Center right after this on Fox Sports Carolina.